Let's just pray together. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for an amazing opportunity we've got just to spend time with one another in your presence. Oh, what a privilege. What a privilege, Father, to spend time with you. Thank you, Father. You're the only living God. And we honor and we worship you for that. We belong to you through the blood of Christ. Father, thank you. You want to speak to us with your word, through your word. And I want to pray and ask, Father, that the seed will fall on good ground, Father. That we will bear much fruit in Jesus' name. I prophesy this over us this morning. And I thank you, Holy Spirit, that you're the one that's faithful, that will reveal, open up the word for us this morning. In Jesus' name, amen, amen. I said to you last week that I want to share with you what Rob DeLuca said, and it was just amazing what Pastor Peter was sharing. Was different, and it was amazing. And Pastor Peter was talking about, listen, it's time to stand. You receive a word, and they prayed for you. But guess what? There will be challenges. And we need to stand on the word. Ephesians 6. We need to stand on the promises of God. Amen? Amazing. What I want to share with you this morning is that when he spoke to us, there were two things that was standing out for me. He gave a prophetic word, an apostolic word, right? The prophetic word that he gave was, God wants to do amazing. What was the word? Unusual miracles today. Amen? You remember it? Oh, do you remember it? Yes, he said God wants to do a miracles already amazing. You understand? But he emphasized it. God wants to do amazing miracles in our lives. And not only, listen carefully, this is what I want to share with you. Not only for us, but also through us. Amen. The second thing, the apostolic word that he said is, church is not only on the Sunday. We sang the song, Burn Like a Fire in Me. He said, it's amazing to sing it. But guess what? We need to go burn the outside. Amen? And that's the challenge, my brother and sister. Not only for you, for me too. We need to be a burning light for His glory. Amen? Yes. The title of my message this morning is, Do You Believe It? Do you believe it? You see, we want to see extraordinary miracles. We want to see them. We want to hear of them. But guess what? God's going to use you. Amen? God wants to use you and me. Normally people. To be supernatural. Amen? Why? Because of the Holy Spirit that dwells inside of us. My brother and sister, if we want to see signs and wonder, guess what? God's going to use us. We His body. We His disciples. If we're going to think somebody else is going to do it, guess what? It's not true. You were not saved to go to heaven. You were saved to bring heaven down to earth. Amen? God saved us to bring heaven down to earth. Jesus prayed, let your kingdom come. Let your will be done in heaven, on earth as it is in heaven. And guess what? He chose you. He chose me. He saved me. He gave us the Holy Spirit. And now He's saying to us, you go. And now we're afraid. We say, ah, Lord, when I look at myself in the mirror, it's impossible. No, it's possible. That's why He gave us His Holy Spirit. You see, and that's why the title is, Do You Believe It? Do you really believe that God wants to use you? You're going to use the high and mighty guys. It's not true. He wants to use you, normal people like me and you. Amen? That's why He gave His Holy Spirit to us. Amen? You will receive power. And you will receive power to go out. Amen? For what? For goosebumps? No. Not for goosebumps. He gave us power to establish His kingdom. And guess what? He wants to use you and me. Amen? If we want to see miracles and signs, guess what? We need to line up and say, Lord, I'm available. I'm afraid. I don't know if I can do it. But Lord, I'm available. Amen? So important. My brother and sister, I believe that word. I believe the word that God said to us through Rob. Extraordinary miracles are going to happen. Amen? And He's going to use us. Amen? What do you believe? Do you believe it? My brother and sister, and we need to renew our mind. Amen? We need to renew our mind. God wants to use us. I'm going to ask my wife to read because of the frog in my voice. I'm going to ask my wife just to read this morning. Let's go to Mark 16. Thank you, Rose. Let's go to Mark 16. Mark 16. And thank you. Remember when he was here, he said he's amazed about how many people are using their Bibles. Do you remember that? It's so excellent. Please bring your Bible with. Mark 16. And we're not going to, let's read. Mark 16. Let's read verse 15 and 16 rounds. Mark 16, verse 15 and 16.
And he said to them, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature.
Yeah.
He who believes and is baptized will be saved, but he who does not believe will be condemned.
He's talking to the disciples. He's telling them, listen, you guys go out now. Preach the gospel. And for those who believe, he's not talking to the disciples. He said, for those who are going to believe, they will be saved. But that's not where he stops. Verse 17.
And these signs will follow those who believe.
Oh, let's stop there. I'm not going to read this. My brother and sister, if you're a believer, just wave at me. Are you a believer? Is Jesus Christ Lord of your life? If you believe, the Bible says these signs will follow you and me. Amen? Do you believe it? Do you believe it? That's the challenge that the Lord gave me. President, do you really believe it? These signs will follow you. And guess what? Let's read it. Last verse. We're not going to read it. Last verse. Verse 20.
And they went out and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word through the accompanying signs. Amen.
Amen. Read it again. Listen.
And they went out and preached everywhere, the Lord working with them and confirming the word through the accompanying signs. Amen.
Amen. My brother and sister, guess what? If you're not going to go out, you won't see miracles. That's a fact. But if you go out, God, listen, God promise, if you go out, I will work miracles through your life. Amen? God's challenging us. We want to see miracles. But guess what? God wants to use us. Normal people, born again, filled with the Holy Spirit. Amen? What do we need to do? Moses, what did Moses do? Moses, God called him up to the mountain. Do you think it was easy for him to go on the mountain? No, it was tough. But for him to see God's face or to spend time with God, he had to go up. My brother and sister, it will cost you something. Amen? If we're not connected, where's the guitar? If the guitar is not connected to power, guess what? No, that's not a good example. But where's the mic? Oh, you've got a mic. If the mic's not connected, nothing will happen. It needs to be connected to the source. Amen? It needs to be connected to the source. Then it will work. And that's why let's go to Luke 11 verse 10. My brother and sister, I'm challenging you this morning. God's challenging me. He gave us a word. He ministered to us, and God was good to us. But God gave a word, and we need to stand on the word. Luke 11, verse 10. Luke 11, verse 10. Aronzi, you can start with 9. Thank you.
So I say to you, ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and it will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened.
Hallelujah. Listen, the lady said it this morning. Remember Jeremiah, where she shared. My brother and sister, I want to tell you, God is faithful. He said, for everyone that seeks him will find him. Everyone. Not some of us, not only the pastor. Everyone. If you seek, you will find him. Read verse 10 again, Rons.
For everyone who asks receives, and he who seeks finds, and to him who knocks it will be opened.
Amen. The question again this morning, do you believe it? Sometimes we say these words, I'm praying, God's not hearing my voice. It's not true. The Bible says God listened to you. And he's a faithful God. Amen. God listened to us. We're going to read other verses also. Let's go to John 7. What do we need to do? We need to seek him. What's number one? We need to seek him and pray. Number two, John 7, verse 37, 38 and 39. Hello?
On the last day, the great day of a feast, Jesus stood and cried out, saying, if anyone thirsts, let him come to me and drink. He who believes in me, as Scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water. But this he spoke concerning the Spirit, whom those believing in him would receive. For the Holy Spirit was not yet given, because Jesus was not yet glorified.
The second point, you need to be thirsty. Jesus said, if you're thirsty, guess what? Streams of living water will flow through us. Amen. My brother and sister, this is God's heart. God wants to establish his kingdom on earth through me and you. But we need to be thirsty. So Lord, I seek you. I'm thirsty. Let's go to John while we are John 15. John 15. The branch and the vine. Verse 7. John 15, verse 7. Thank you.
If you abide in me and my words abide in you, you will ask what you desire and it shall be done for you.
Verse 8.
By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit, so you will be my disciples.
Amen. The connection here is not, Lord, I want a Lamborghini, please send me. That's not what he's talking about. What he's talking about here, to be an effective disciple. You can ask what you want if you want to be an effective disciple of Jesus Christ. Amen? And that includes to do what Christ did. Amen? My brothers and sisters, this is the Father's heart. Let's go to Luke 12. Luke 12. Stay in the vine. Stay connected to God. Seek His face. Luke 12, verse 31 and 32.
But seek the kingdom of God, and all these things shall be added to you. Do not fear, little flock, for it is your Father's good pleasure to give you the kingdom.
It's God's good pleasure to give us what? The kingdom. Hallelujah. The Father's heart is to bless you with His kingdom. The fullness that's in His kingdom. Amen. My brother and sister, this is our God. He's a good God. He wants to give you His kingdom so that you will establish His kingdom here on earth. Amen. So important. Right. Remember what I'm asking this morning. Do you believe it? Do you believe God wants to give you His kingdom to you? So important. My brother and sister, let's go to 1 Peter. 1 Peter 3 verse 12. We read a few verses this morning. I just want to emphasize, God listened to us. Verse 1 Peter 3, verse 12. Thank you, Runs.
For the eyes of the Lord are on the righteous, and His ears are open to their prayers.
Okay, just that first portion. What God promised, my brother says, His eyes are fixed on you, and that He listened to your prayer. Why are we doubting? Again and again and again, God's promising to us, listen, I'm listening to you. I'm listening to your prayer. My eyes are on you. The third thing I want to say to you that's very important is that Pastor Peter also said last week, without faith, it's impossible to please God. We need to believe God's listening to us. We need to believe He wants to use us. We need to believe it, my brother and sister. Why do God wants to use us? I'm not going to go to Genesis. Let's go to Psalm 8, verse 7. Remember in Genesis, God said to Adam and Eve, have dominion, rule and reign the earth. I just want to show you this again. It's so important. Psalm 8, verse, I think let's read verse 3, Ransi, and then verse 7. Listen to the scripture. Thank you.
When I consider your heavens, the works of your fingers, the moon and the stars which you have ordained. That's verse 3.
Verse 3.
Okay, yeah. And then?
And verse 7, sorry.
6. I think you want 6.
In the English, it's 6. Yeah, okay, six. Sorry.
You have made him to have dominion over the works of your hands, and you have put all things under his feet.
Oh, listen. Read again.
You have made him to have dominion.
Sorry, read verse 5 perhaps just before that.
For you have made him a little lower than the angels.
Yeah.
And you have crowned him with glory and honor.
Glory means king, kingship, right?
You have made him to have dominion over the works of your hands. You have put all things under his feet.
Important, my brother and sister. God gave us authority, dominion over everything on earth. And God gave us authority over everything on earth. Let's go to Psalm 115. Psalm 115. It's verse, let's start with 15 perhaps, runs. 115, verse 15, but it's 16 I want us to look at.
15, may you be blessed by the Lord who made heaven and earth.
We are blessed. Right now, verse 16.
The heavens, even the heavens, are the Lord's, but the earth he has given to the children of men.
Amen. I want you to see this, my brother and sister. God gave us dominion on earth. Adam, Eve lost it. Christ got it back. And now Jesus Christ gave it to us. And now he's saying, we need to rule over everything on earth. Let's go to Hebrews. Just to show you so that you see that God is promising something to us and we need to believe it. Hebrews 2. Let's read verse 4, Rance. Hebrews 2, verse 4.
God also bearing witness both with signs and wonders, with various miracles and gifts of the Holy Spirit, according to his own will.
Okay, God wants to, my brother and sister, God wants to do miracles in our midst. Let's go, all right, verse 5, 6, and 7.
For he has not put the world to come of which we speak in subjection to angels, but one testified in a certain place saying, what is man that you are mindful of him, or the son of man that you take care of him?
Now verse 6, very important. Oh, 7.
You have made him a little lower than the angels. You have crowned him with glory and honor and set him over the works of your hands.
Amen. There's no doubt. The word declared, God gave us authority over everything here on earth. It's our responsibility to rule and to reign with him. Amen? My brother and sister, God is doing something. Let's read the next verse perhaps also. Verse 8.
You have put all things in subjection under his feet.
All things, not some. All things. Read it again.
You have put all things in subjection under his feet. For in that he put all in subjection under him, he left nothing that is not put under him.
Yeah.
But now we do not yet see all things put under him.
Right, and then the first portion, verse 9.
But we see Jesus.
Yeah. Right, my brother and sister, what he's saying here, the Hebrew writer is saying, listen, everything's supposed to be under our feet. Remember, Christ is the head. The church is his body, Ephesians 1, verse 23 and 25, I believe. But Christ is the head. The church is his body. And the enemy is supposed to be under our feet. We're supposed to rule and reign over the works of the devil. Amen? So important that we would know this. But then he said, not everything at this moment is subjective. Why? Sometimes we fail. But even if we fail, our eyes are fixed on Christ. Because he said, it is finished. He paid the full price. And that's why, my brother and sister, God is calling me and you to be vessels for his glory. Amen? Amen? Amen. If you're saved, baptized with the Holy Spirit, you qualify to build his kingdom. Last verse. Let's go to Matthew 17. Matthew 17. What's the title of verse 4? What's the title there in your Bible? The Mount Sycophant. Matthew 17. 17. 17:1-7. Right. We're not going to read everything. Remember, a father brought his child to the Jesus brought, a father brought his son to the disciples while Jesus was on the Mount of Transfiguration. And they prayed for them and nothing happened to the son. And then when Jesus and John and James arrived, Peter, they arrived. The father took the son to Jesus. Say, listen, I asked your disciples to pray for him, but nothing happened. Right, and I don't want to focus a lot on that. Read verse 17, please. Matthew 17:7.
Then Jesus answered and said, O faithless and perverse generation, how long shall I be with you? How long shall I bear with you? Bring him here to me.
Right, verse 18.
And Jesus rebuked the demon, and it came out of him. And the child was cured from that very hour.
19.
Then the disciples came to Jesus privately and said, why could we not cast it out?
Now this is important. Verse 20.
So Jesus said to them, because of your unbelief, for assuredly I say to you, if you have faith as a mustard seed, you will say to this mountain, move from here to there, and it will move, and nothing will be impossible for you.
Hallelujah. And nothing will be impossible for you. But guess what? You need to get rid of unbelief. The way you get rid of unbelief, the answer, he gives us the answer, verse 21. Thank you, verse 21.
However, this kind does not go out except by prayer and fasting.
Prayer and fasting, my brother and sister. Do you see that we need to spend time with God? We need to spend time with God. Be connected to the vine. We need to be connected to God. Spend time with Him. Seek Him. Thirst for Him. And then He declares streams of living water will flow through us. Not only for a few of us. Not only the pastors. For those who believed. For those who believe. And I believe it includes all of us perhaps this morning. The question I'm ending with this morning, do you believe it? Do you believe that God can or wants to use you? Amen? God wants to use you. Let's use the opportunity. Amen? I'm going to Adimula, use the testimony of Adimula. They won a course, I think it's in Bella Bella, it doesn't matter where. And God just told him, listen, pray for this guy. And he was also afraid, like me. But he said, Lord, I will do it. Pray for someone. My brother and sister, if we don't go out, guess what? Nothing will happen. It's a guarantee. But we need to go out. We need to believe God wants to use me. Amen? God wants to use me. I need to go out. I quickly want to testify before I close. We've got problems with water. I don't know if you've got problems with water, but we've got problems with water. The last 7 months, nothing, no water. And I phoned the guy, actually went there, spoke to him, and he said he will have come and have a look. He came, and this part, week, Thursday, he came in, and he was in our church. I hope he's not, is he here? But it's a good testimony. So he said, listen, you know I'm a pastor, because he was once in our church. He said, listen, pastor, the guy who knew where the valves are, he's on pension. He's not here anymore. And the other guy is sick, and he's also on pension. At this stage, they don't know where's the valve. And I did not scream, luckily, on him because I'm a pastor. But listen carefully what happened. Afterwards, God just told me, listen, why didn't you pray for wisdom? We've got the answer. And I'm going to call him and I'm going to pray for him that God will give him wisdom so that he can solve our problem with no water. You see, small opportunities, God wants to use us. Amen? Let's be sensitive. I'm going to challenge you this morning. Let's be sensitive. Say, Holy Spirit, I want you to lead me. Help me to build God's kingdom here in town. Amen? God wants to give his kingdom to us. God's desire is to give his kingdom to us. To do what? To build his kingdom here on earth. And he wants to use you. Amen? God wants to use us. Let's just pray. Thank you, Holy Father, that you send your Son, Jesus Christ, to this earth to save us. But not only save us, but to equip us to establish your kingdom here on earth. Thank you, Father, that you said to us this morning with a few scriptures that we've got the rulership, dominion on earth. You chose the human being to rule for you here on earth. And that's us. Father, thank you, you send your word. For those who believed, these signs shall follow them. Father, and I want to pray for each one of us, although we are afraid and shy and think it's impossible, Father, that we will believe your word. You promise everyone that asks will receive. You promise us this morning, your eyes are fixed on us, the righteous, and you listen to our prayers. And Father, I want to pray for each one of us. Help us to be strong in you, led by your Spirit, that we will a shining light of your kingdom, that people will glorify you when signs and wonders start flowing through our lives. Thank you, Father, you promise us this morning again. For those who went out, you worked with. And I want to pray for each one of us this morning. Father, each one of us, how small, how old, how young, help us. Help us that the Holy Spirit will use us in a mighty way so that you will be glorified. Father, we believe your word. We believe your word. Thank you, Father, that we will testify of the things that happened in us, but also through our lives. That's our prayer. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Amen.